Hello, I'm Marcy Jacklin. I'm the Liaison Librarian for Biological Sciences and Tourism Management here at Brock University Library. The purpose of this video is to introduce you to a bibliographic manager called Endnote. Bibliographic managers help you collect, organize, and produce bibliographies from your citations. So let's get started with setting up a free account that's available through web with knowledge. So we're going to go to the library homepage, www.brocku.ca/library, and drop down the research link and click on databases and go over to W4 Web of Science Core Collection and connect. To get an account, you need to either sign in with your login and password that you already have established, or register your new login and password. I already have one, so I'm going to sign in. Now that you have an account, you can enter the Endnote software by clicking at the top of the screen, Endnote. And you can see that I already have some references in here, and also some folders or groups where I've been organizing my citations. You can create new groups by clicking on Organize and then Manage My Groups and adding a new group. This allows you to put citations that you need for a specific essay all into one place, and it also allows you to put citations that might be good for more than one essay into different groups. Okay, so now what we're going to do is import some citations so you can see how that process works. First, we'll start off with Web of Science, so I'm going to click on Web of Science up here. Just so you know, Web of Science is composed of several databases, including in the core collection, the Web of Science database, BIOSIS, which is a very good database for biology, as is Medline. Also keep in mind that Web of Science includes citations to social sciences and humanities. So I'm going to do a basic search here. And I'm going to search under the topic, but you could also put keywords in that would could be found in the author or years published, and you could add other fields so that you can focus your search and get better results. I'm going to search this particular topic, and you can see I have lots of results here. I can narrow it down by just searching in science, for instance, and refining. And I can also pick research areas and refine further. You can see each time I refine that my list of results gets smaller and more focused. I can also put in keywords here to refine my results, and I can refine it by other things like journal titles or publication years. The display can be organized many different ways, so I can organize it by the newest first. Some people like to do it by relevance, so you see more of your keywords in the title. And you can also organize it by how many times the paper has been cited. Obviously, really new papers won't be at the top of this list, but this paper from 1996 has been cited 346 times, which usually indicates that it was a classic paper, very important to the literature in the area of climate change. Okay, what I'd like to do now is show you how to put some of these citations into your EndNote account. So I'm going to just kind of browse through these titles and see if there are titles that I would be interested in having in my EndNote for potentially for a paper, or perhaps they will be a key resource for one of my papers. And then I'm going to save it to EndNote Online. I can choose what I send over, so author title, title of the journal, obviously, but I also have the option of including the abstract in this format, so I'm going to select that as well and send it. And you can see it's indicating that the records have been sent. When I go back to my EndNote, I can see under my references that there are two citations here that haven't been filed. And I can mark these and add them to any group. And again, I could also add them to several groups if I wanted to. Now I'm going to go to my list here and click on one of the titles to show you what it looks like. So you can see it's given me the information I need to cite this paper, so it's got the authors, the title of the article, the year, the title of the journal, the volume, the issue, and the pages, as well as the abstract. It also lets me connect to the Brock full text databases, so I can click on the Get It key here. And that will tell me in this case that it is available full text. You may not be able to find it full text. It may tell you if it's in print. And the other option is that you can get it through RACER or Interlibrary Loan System from another university. I'm going to click on the full text, and usually that takes you to the bibliographic information and the abstract and allows you to click on a full text version, in this case PDF. EndNote also allows you to create bibliographies with your citations. To do that, you would go into Format and click on Bibliography. You can choose all your references, or you can choose the group that you would like to create a bibliography with. And you can choose a style. And the interesting thing about EndNote is that there are hundreds of styles to choose from. Part of the reason being that almost every journal has its own style. I'm just going to select one of the classic styles, APA 6, but you can see there's lots of choice here. And you can select the file format, so HTML, plain text, and you can decide if you want to save it, email to yourself, or preview and print. So I'm going to just click on preview and print. And you can see it creates it quite quickly. You do need to scan it for errors. I can see a couple already. For instance, this title is all in upper case, so you either change that in your file or you change it directly into your EndNote record. So download this module called Cite While You Write. It's a plugin, and that allows you to integrate EndNote with Word, and so it does in-text citations as well as the bibliography at the end in the style that you choose. Just another reminder that you need to check your information, because sometimes the database presents information into EndNote in a different manner than is required. For instance, we saw the capital letters. And make sure you watch out for two other videos where I talk about moving citations from Google Scholar to EndNote and from SuperSearch to EndNote. Thank you for your attention.